Thank you, Essen. Thank you, Teresa. Oh, wow, there's so many people here. This is exciting. So my name is Jodie. I am a second-year PhD student in the Radiological Sciences program, and that's going to be the only time I introduce myself that way, because within Radiological Sciences, what I actually study is medical physics. Everyone has heard of radiology, but if you say medical physics, you're going to raise a lot more eyebrows, you're going to spark a lot more conversations when you say that. So I'm Jodie. I'm studying medical physics right now. Tonight you're going to hear lots of really cool stories from my colleagues about the day that they woke up and knew they were going to be a scientist. My story is a little bit different. It's a story of someone who was interested in what seemed like way too many sciences all at the same time and trying to find her path. So I studied physics as an undergraduate as a subject, it's pretty broad as far as sciences go, and for some reason I was good at it. I don't know how that happened. And I also studied philosophy. It turned out that I enjoyed thinking about science just as much as I enjoyed doing it. So subjects of philosophy of science, theory of mind, these things were just as cool to me as the physics that I was learning in the classroom and in the lab. So by the time I graduated, I had heard of graduate school. I'd heard of getting your doctorate. It sounded like a cool thing for me, but if I could only narrow down what it was I wanted to study. So I wasn't ready to make that leap yet. So I was sworn into my institution's master's program for computer science, even though I'd never written a line of code in my life. They just said, you'll be fine. Just go for it. I was fine eventually, and it turned out that I loved computer science too. So it seemed like I was casting an even wider net for myself, but luckily amid all of these studies, I did go to a conference where I heard a woman give a very cool presentation on medical physics. I'd never heard of it before. But I did more research, I heard about UTESCA, and then I ended up here. So an antiquated definition for what medical physics actually is, very generally, any time that you have radiation in medicine, you want a physicist present, and that happens quite a bit. Our program is about 4 years long, so we do about 2 years of coursework, your qualifying examinations, and then research for your dissertation, then you're done. Many of us will go on to take boards and complete residencies, much like medical students do. And then when you're done, there's about three general things you can do as a medical physicist. The first would be, if you want to bring home the big bucks, you can be a therapy physicist. They work alongside oncologists to help plan radiation treatments for cancer therapy. Another major branch of medical physics would be that of health physics. So that is maintaining radiation safety in places like UTESCA and in hospitals and whatnot. So our own environmental health and safety officer here at UTESCA, Dr. Michael Charlton, he is also a certified medical health physicist. So in addition to making sure we do safe radiation practices here, he's also the person who gets called when someone in the dental building burns a bag of popcorn and the fire trucks have to come. So please pop responsibly, everyone, for Michael Charlton. And then the other major sect of medical physics would be that of imaging physics, so using radiation and other new things nowadays to image the human body. So what I get to do, I work over in the Research Imaging Institute. I get to do all of the cool things that I really like. Perfect intersection. I do data mining on massive amounts of brain data in people who suffer from depression. Just a really cool intersection of all of these fields. I do have quite a passion for mental health, research and mental illness. It's kind of a mysterious field right now, so what we're doing, studying the physical mechanisms and markers we can actually see in the brain for people who have these disorders, I think it's going to be big news someday, and UTESCA is the perfect place for me. I'm glad I'm here. Thanks, guys.